movement and time. Hello friends, can you feel that the earth is moving? But you are standing where you were. We know that the speed of some vehicles on the road is slow and some fast. But what is speed? When all of you get up in the morning, go to school, eat food, study, I'm sure you look at me because I tell you the time. Let us find out through this video the relationship between speed, motion and time. The objectives of this video: A. To gather information about speed and movement. B. To understand the relation between speed and time.
Ram, you have to take part in a race in the nearby village school tomorrow. Hurry up and sleep, otherwise you will not be able to wake up in the morning.
Oh, how does this watch come to know each morning that it is time to wake me up? It wakes me up at the correct time. Kaki, please call Shyam. We have to go early, otherwise the bus will leave.
Ram, Shyam has already left. Run and go. He must not have reached yet.
The bus will leave. Let me run and go. If I had an aeroplane, I would have reached early. Oh, the bus just left. Shyam is sitting in the bus. It is 7 a.m. Shyam will reach before me. The next bus will come in 10 minutes. It looks like I will get late. Shyam would have reached. Oh, the bus in which he left has reached now.
Hey Ram, you have already reached.
Yes, it is strange. I left in the bus which came after you left, but I reached before you.
I think your bus was faster than my bus.
The distance from our village to this village is 10 kilometers. I reached in 30 minutes and you took 40 minutes.
So it means that your bus took less time to cover a distance of 10 kilometers.
Yes, because my bus did not stop anywhere.
My bus also did not stop.
Friends, the speed of the vehicles moving fast is more. To find out which vehicle is moving at a faster speed, we will have to know the distance travelled by them in a particular time. The distance travelled by objects in a given time helps us in deciding this.
Are you ready for the race, Ram?
Ready, children? I am going to begin the count from 3. 3, 2, 1.
Shyam, Mohan won the race. We have both come second.
It means that both of us ran at the same speed. Come, let us ask Sir, how much time did we take to complete the race?
Shyam and Ram, you took 4 minutes to complete the race. And Mohan took 3.2 minutes.
I want to know who was faster, Ram or me?
Children, whenever there is a race in your school, there is a starting point and an end point. The winner is the one who finishes this distance in the least time. To find out the speed of the object, we have to find how much distance it covers in a unit time. This is known as the speed of the vehicle. Therefore, you can find out the speed of a vehicle by finding out the distance it covered and the time taken to cover that distance. Therefore, speed is equal to distance divided by time. So if Shyam and Ram covered a distance of 100 meter in 4 minutes, then what was their speed?
Children, it is important to take part in a competition. Winning and losing is part of the game.
I think it was because of speed that I reached before you in the morning. Because the speed of my bus was more than the speed of your bus. We shall ask about the speed of the bus from the bus driver when we return home.
Look, Ram, what is this? Sand is falling down when I turn it upside down.
Children, this is an hourglass. When the ancient people did not have watches, they used this to find out the time.
It is so creditable, Shyam, that the people of the ancient times did not have watches, but they could tell the time by looking at the sunrise and sunset.
Nowadays, there are so many different types of watches. Like our coach had the stopwatch, with the help of which he was noting the time we took in finishing the race.
Remember, we had read that the king of Jaipur had made the sun clock in Jantar Mantar.
It will be interesting to find out how the watches tell us the correct time.
We had studied that watches use the rotation motion, but the watches are so small, how is it possible for them to have the rotatory motion inside them?
Driver uncle, can you tell us the speed of the bus?
What happened, children? Do you have to reach somewhere quickly?
No, actually we want to understand about speed. We wanted to understand how much time will it take us to reach home.
Look children, there is this device in vehicles which is known as speedometer. It tells us the speed the vehicle is moving at. Like the speed of this bus is 60 km per hour.
If the bus is moving at a speed of 60 km per hour, then how much distance is it covering in 1 minute?
Hey kids, let the driver brother drive the bus carefully. Tell me, how many minutes are there in 1 hour?
60 minutes.
And your question was, how much distance would the bus cover in a minute?
Didi, is 60 minutes to an hour? So if this bus is covering a distance of 60 km in an hour, it means that it will cover 1 km in 1 minute.
Correct answer. Do you know how the units are related to each other?
Didi, the basic unit of time is seconds and the big units are minutes and hours.
And what is the root unit of the speed? Didi, because speed is equal distance upon time, that's why meter per second is the basic unit of speed. Well done, and it is also expressed in other units, meter per minute or kilometer per hour.
Can you tell how many seconds are in a day and how many hours in a year?
I want to become a pilot when I grow up. The speed of plane is very fast.
And I want to grow up to become a mathematician.
And I am thinking that the speed of the rocket will be faster than the plane. I want to know more about this. Oh wow! Well done, children!
So friends, if a bus or a vehicle is moving slowly, then we say that its speed is less. And if the same vehicle is moving fast, then we say its speed is more. In this way, we can say that by the speed of the object, we get to know how slowly or fast an object is moving. Now we can define it in such a way that the distance travelled by the object in unit time is called the speed of the object, such as 60 km per hour, 10 m per second, etc. See you friends!